apostles. Peter saw Jesus Christ feeling feeling. Peter denied Jesus Christ. Peter received the power of the Holy Ghost on the day of Pentecost. Peter declared the word of God with boldness before 5,000 people, led many to Christ. Peter saw the Lord. Peter touched the Lord. So when we are talking about somebody who knows the Lord and who is telling us the truth, it is Peter and not some PhD somewhere. Who doesn't know what he's talking about? Peter was hung upside down. He died hanging upside down. Peter was persecuted. Fierce persecution. He went through all that. Those are the people you and I have to listen to. But when they are talking about the word of God, they are the ones who listen to, not somebody who, because of his status in life, can spew out all kinds of lies, telling you that eternal security, once saved, always saved, it is not possible for you, a believer, to go to hell. My friend, it is not true. He said, ye therefore, beloved, see ye now, ye know these things, and all of us, and I'll keep on stressing it in the church, in all nations, you'll be hearing it from me over and over again, so that none of us will live a careless lifestyle. I've always said this, Jesus Christ, there is coming a day when Jesus Christ will say to some of us, if not all of us, I never knew you. Hallelujah. And don't let anybody say that person maybe didn't know Jesus Christ from the beginning. That person once knew the Lord, but he backslid. Hallelujah. So beware lest ye also be led away with the error of the wicked. Fall from your own what? Fall from your own what? Steadfastness. If that is not dangerous, Peter wouldn't have put it there.
That's right.
Hallelujah. If falling away from your steadfastness is not a dangerous thing, Peter wouldn't put it here.
Amen.
It is dangerous.
Yes.
Paul also followed up in the book of Hebrews. Paul says that it is impossible. And then he also says that beware, for it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of God, of the living God. But grow in grace, in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Beloved, this is the word of God for us tonight. We've heard the consequences of wickedness, consequences of willful neglect, willful rejection of God. The consequences of willful rejection of God. And when we reject God and we refuse to retain God in our hearts and mind, God gives us up to reprobate mind. And we practice reprobation. And the fruit of reprobation is wickedness. And all those things are listed in the book of Romans. It is my prayer tonight. If you are practicing lesbian, please repent from that wicked ways. Repent and turn your life over unto Jesus Christ. It is not too late. You are not too far away from salvation. The blood of Jesus Christ is available to cleanse and to make you whole. Jesus Christ will save and set you free. If you are practicing homosexual, don't, my friend, excuse yourself and don't flatter yourself. It is evil. Repent from that wicked ways. Turn your life unto Jesus Christ. Don't let any politician flatter you. He's after your votes. He's not interested in your soul. He's only after your vote, so he says it's all right. But my friend, Jesus Christ loves you. He died for you. He wants to set you free from the bondage of sin, from the clutches of Satan. Repent and turn away from your life of lesbianism, from your life of homosexuality, from your life of fornication, from your life of adultery, from your life of masturbation. Repent from those things. And turn to the Lord Jesus Christ tonight. So much lies have filled our churches. Young boys, young girls say, oh, I have pledged to the Lord. I am, what do you call it, some kind of covenant they've made. And yet behind the doors, they know what they are practicing. Repent from the life of masturbation. Turn from that sin. It will ruin your life. And it will pave the way to a place that you don't want to go. Amen. That place is God, is called hell. Turn away from that sin, that wickedness. Jesus Christ sees you in that secret place. You think your parents are not watching you. You think your friends don't see you. You think your pastor doesn't see. But there's one person who sees it. His name is Jesus Christ. Any sin that is committed is outside of the body. But the sin of fornication. Masturbation is fornication. It's fornication against your own self. With yourself. Fornication with yourself. Homosexuality is man and man. Masturbation is man and his own self. And then lesbianism is woman and woman. These are all wickedness that God will judge. We need to repent from these sins. Repent and turn away from it, America. Turn from it, the whole world. In the name of Jesus Christ. This is the word of God tonight to us. And my prayer tonight is that somebody somewhere, if not all of us, will come unto the knowledge of God as we turn away from our sins. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Shall we arise unto our feet? My Jesus, I love you. I know thou art mine. For thee, all the follies of sin, I resign. Oh, my grace, just redeemer, my Savior, thou art my love of you, my Jesus. Now. Oh, my grace, just redeemer, my Savior, if ever I love you, my Jesus, now. Oh, my Jesus, I love you, I know.
Oh.
say this after me. Lord Jesus Christ, I have heard your word. I believe your word. I confess that I have sinned against you. I have wandered far away from you. I am guilty of the things that the word of God has spoken today. But I thank you for the blood that you shed at Calvary. Tonight, Lord Jesus, I repent from all my sins. I repent from my life of fornication. I repent from my life of lesbianism. I repent from my life of homosexuality. I repent from my life of adultery. I repent from my life of murder. I repent from my sin of abortion. I repent, Lord. Have mercy upon me and forgive me this day. Wash me with the blood of Jesus Christ and make me whole. Yes, Lord, plunge me in the blood. Plunge me in the blood of Jesus Christ. Plunge me in the blood of Jesus Christ. Plunge me in the blood of Jesus Christ. Purify my conscience. Make me whole today. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. And cause me to live a life of holiness, of righteousness, and of obedience to your perfect will. Do this, Father, for your name's sake and for your glory's sake. I thank you for hearing me. I thank you for hearing me. I thank you for hearing me. Now I'm going to pray for you. Heavenly Father, the word you placed in my heart to deliver to this city, to this county, to this state, to this nation, Father, I have believed it. I have kept nothing back. I have delivered unto them every word that is written in the book of Romans, in the book of 2 Peter chapter 3. I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that the power of your Holy Spirit will arrest many souls and bring many unto repentance by your word, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for a mighty shaking in this nation, that this nation will turn from our wicked ways, that we will surrender our all unto you, O God, through Jesus Christ, like the city of Nineveh did in the day when Jonah proclaimed the word of repentance unto them. So I pray for a mighty shaking in the nation of America, that this nation will turn from our wicked ways and surrender our whole lives unto you, O God, through Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords and Prince of Peace. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ, Father, over the White House. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over the Congress, over the Senate. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over the Supreme Court and the Justice Department. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over the State Department and the Defense Department. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over every governor's mansion in the name of Jesus. Oh, that the whole nation will come to repentance. The whole nation will come unto repentance. That will seek Jesus Christ. That will come to know him of the truth. In Jesus' name, deliver us from all our flatteries. Deliver us from all our flatteries. Give us a new heart, a new mind, a new soul, a new spirit that walks in righteousness, in holiness, in purity, and in truth. In the mighty, matchless name of Jesus Christ. Let this river break into the continents of the whole earth. Africa, Europe, Asia, South America, Antarctica. Yes, my Father, the Middle and the Far East. I pray they all come to know Jesus Christ. Israel will come to know Jesus Christ. India will come to know Jesus Christ. The Palestinians will come to know Jesus Christ. All the Arabs will come to know Jesus Christ. My Father, I pray in every continent that they will turn unto Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. I voice the name of Jesus Christ above the skies of all the continents, that they will all look up to Jesus Christ, the only Savior, the only way, the only truth, and the only life. Yes, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, move by the power of your Holy Spirit. Let there be a shaking. Even as you held back the rain tonight, so I pray that you show yourself strong in the nations of the whole earth, as you shake the very foundations of the nations, that they will turn their hearts unto you, the living God, that they will serve you in spirit and in truth. For it is in the name of Jesus Christ, the name that is above every name, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Jesus Christ, the soon coming King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, the righteous judge, Jesus Christ, the holiest of all. Father, it is in the name of Jesus I have prayed with thanksgiving. Thank you, Father, for hearing. In the saints of God, we shall all sing. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't you have a liberty? On Wednesday night, Wednesday we talk, we celebrated July 4th.
Yes.
But do we indeed have liberty? Do we have liberty from sin?
Yes.
We may have political liberty, but we don't have the liberty from sin. But tonight you and I can sing, I have our liberty. If you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, that is the true liberty. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So let's sing that song together. I have my liberty. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I have my liberty. I have my liberty. I have my liberty. I'm not afraid.
I pray that you heard the word of God tonight and your heart is burning with the desire to turn to the Lord and to be obedient to his holy word. Amen. We want to invite you to our services, our weekly services. Every Sunday morning at 9:30, we have the Sunday school. You can join us to study the word of God. Then we have the morning worship service at 10:45. We have a lively worship service where you can be free to worship and praise the living God. Then on Wednesday, we have Bible study. You're welcome to join us. And we usually have a meal after our Bible study. On Friday night, we have the outdoor crusade. You are welcome. You are invited. You are welcome. This is the house of God where everyone is invited. Everyone is invited. Everyone is somebody. In Jesus' name, amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen.
One more thing we forgot. We have an intensive prayer service next week, Saturday, here at 10 o'clock. Yes. Intensive prayer, intensive prayer by the youth wing of the church. We invite you, if you are a lover of prayer, come and be part of it. And then it will be first of this month, there is a CQ event, which is also at 5 o'clock. At Calvary Church over on by the airport side. Okay, God bless you.